I'm Chris Weber with Styra, and when I think of best practices moving into 2020, think about authorization across your app stack in kind of three ways. Define it, make it decoupled, make it declarative. I know it's not the hottest part of the gig, but if you can define your authorization policy, what can do what, who can do what, with your legal team, your IT security team, your compliance team, and get that figured out up front, you're going to save yourself a world of hurt on the back end when you get into production. Second piece, make it decoupled. Don't waste time integrating authorization or hand-building it into your app or into your infrastructure. From Kubernetes to service mesh into the app itself, find a way to get the authorization decisions externalized to that. And then that last piece, be declarative. Use those downstream APIs to actually do the enforcement when you're using some policy engine to do the context-aware decision-making. You've got everything you need in the apps with those APIs, in the environment, in the infrastructure. Take advantage of them, work in a declarative way, define what can happen so you don't have to worry about what could happen.
Hello, my name is Klaus Jepsen. I'm the deputy CTO at Unit 4. In 2020 and going forward, I think we're going to see a tremendous shift away from the monolithic user experience that we today see in ERP solution and other enterprise software packages, where over time we have built up these very complex user interfaces that requires end users to go in and actually search for what they're going to do. It doesn't come natural. It's very complicated and takes long to learn. It's very frustrating to work with. So I think we're going to see a shift into what I call sort of focused task app or purpose-built apps, where the interaction with the user is a function of a system requiring the end users to do something in the system. And this is triggered by a conversational messaging where the end user is in a chat with a chatbot will be alerted that he or she needs to go in and do expenses, approve supplier invoices, or you know, there can be something within the year-end review in the HCM space. So whenever this notification happens, it's going to come as a conversational user experience. Then in many cases, these tasks can then be handled directly in the chat with the chatbot. However, in some cases, there can be too many lines. For example, if you have to approve an invoice, that you need to actually look at each line. And then instead of then sending people back to the monolithic user experience, where what's going to happen is that we're going to see a new kind of apps coming up that's specifically designed to handle that task, like a special area where you can approve invoices, you can do your expenses, and then the users can do that. When they're done, they will shut it down, and they're good to go on to work on what they really want to work on rather than maintaining data inside the ERP system. So 2020 going forward is going to be the demolition of the monolithic user experience and new people experience. It's a combination of conversational user experience together with target app focused apps that essentially will improve the overall people experience of using enterprise software. Thank you.
So when I think about how technology is going to change in the IT industry in 2020, you know, I have to kind of step back, look at the crystal ball and realize that we're at an incredible tipping point right now with technology innovation throughout the IT industry. I can't help but be fascinated by the thought of a fault-tolerant quantum computing engine and how it could speed up AI and machine learning. And then, what are the real and truly big questions that we could attack? But for now, I think we need to think about the ramifications of the pure and simple size of the data universe. IDC estimates that the data universe will crack the 40 zettabyte mark in 2020. That's a 4 with 22 zeros at the end. And as amazing as that is, what I really struggle wrapping my head around is that 90% of that data was generated in the last 2 years alone. But if I take my head out of the cloud, I think the way we collect, secure, store, access, and analyze data will represent the largest change to our industry in the next year. The scale that weighs the value of your work product when intelligence workers have open access to all data versus locking everything down and limiting access to every piece of data to enhance data privacy and security, it's a daunting problem that's plaguing countless business leaders this year. Data privacy will continue to evolve and remain a top concern with the onset of GDPR, CCPA, and upcoming legislation being written across the country, starting with states like California, Nevada, New York, and Washington leading the charge. Data privacy will continue to change the way we work with data throughout 2020. But data security will certainly become even more challenging this year, especially in the SMB space, where most organizations simply can't keep up with the pace of cybersecurity and they are typically unable to maintain a truly secure posture that protects them and their clients' data. For this reason alone, I think we will see another uptick in infrastructure as a service and software as a service adoption this year, even in laggard industries. But then you think about the impact that artificial intelligence and machine learning will have across all of these areas. From deciphering false alerts and remote monitoring to analyzing network traffic and preventing malicious attacks to then visualizing the endless streams of information coming into our data centers. Then you can also consider the impact of technologies like 5G and how that's going to affect how and when our clients use Wi-Fi. Technology innovation is happening so fast, it has become challenging to determine which technology will make the largest impact, with the only consistent variable remaining is that more change is coming and it's going to arrive at an alarming pace. So as we become always connected at home and at work, we generate more and more data every year and encroach yottabytes in storage, our impact as a managed service provider and the way we secure and manage our clients' data will uncover exponentially higher levels of value that we can drive for our clients in 2020.